Welcome to the eighth week of the Powering Agriculture MOOC on Sustainable Energy for Food. Within that initiative, USAID, the governments of Sweden and Germany, as well as Duke Energy and OPIC, promote clean energy solutions in the agriculture and food sector. For the MOOC, the partners are cooperating with TH Kim, a University of Applied Science based in Cologne, Germany.
Hello, how are you? Did you already upload the assignment for week 7? I hope so. Like in the assignment of week 2, you will get comments from your peers. And by the end of this week, I expect to finish reading your assignment and then you will get the aggregated feedback. As you already know, we are now in week 8. This is our final week. In today's lecture, I will summarize and close the whole course. I will also give you some information on final examination at the end. Let's recap the whole course first. During week 1, you got an introduction to the importance of food energy nexus to agro-value chain. In their videos, different experts had provided you detailed information in this regard. In week 2, we discussed different renewable energy resources. Thank you for your hard work to complete the assignment. The topic for week 3 was about bioenergy. Are you already thinking to install a biogas plant to utilize your kitchen waste? In the fourth week, I gave you a lecture on energy efficiency and environmental life cycle assessment. I think the quizzes for that week were very easy, right? In week 5, you got an overview on existing policies to promote renewable energy and sustainable development. Please note that such policies are one of the most important instruments to achieve set targets and goals on renewable energy, also in your country. During the sixth week, you had an opportunity to learn different financial analysis tools, such as cost-benefit analysis and more. We met during week 7 to discuss the business models. Did you already submit your assignment? I wish some of you will now invest your savings in this project, provided your calculated net present value is encouraging for investment. I will read your assignments this week while you are preparing for your examination. Unlike in previous weeks, we do not have a reader document explaining the contents in this week. However, you can find a checklist to identify and implement the appropriate energy solutions and the list of potential financing institutions in this sector. Now, let's talk about the final examination. You will get objective type questions. You are already familiar with such questions during quizzes. This will help us for fast and automatic correction. After you pass this examination, and provided you have already obtained the required numbers of badges during previous weeks, you are eligible to receive the certificate, confirming your successful participation in this online course. I think this certificate will be useful to you. Now we are at the end. Hopefully, you learned something useful during these 8 weeks. I actually enjoyed a lot to offer you this course. Please don't hesitate to knock my office door when you are in the city of Cologne in Germany. Or who knows, perhaps one day we will meet each other in your country next to a renewable energy plant installed for powering agriculture. All the best for your examination. Thank you and take care. Bye-bye.
Thank you for your attention.